Hello there, this is Purti from Leverage Edu and I'm back with yet another video. If you haven't already subscribed to the channel, please do so. In this video today, I'll talk about how to use fillers in your IELTS speaking exam. Let's start with the question, what are fillers? These are words or phrases which can be used to buy time when you don't know what to say. So imagine the examiner asks you a question. You know the answer, but you just need a couple of seconds to gather your thoughts. So this is when you can use these words so that you don't remain silent, because that would be just awkward, right? The examiner might get the impression that you haven't understood the question or you don't know what to say. Now, native speakers use fillers all the time while speaking, so there's nothing wrong in using them. But let me warn you about something. You will use fillers in your speaking test only when you're asked to give your opinion on something or to imagine a situation. Don't use them when you are asked direct questions. For instance, the examiner asks you, where do you live? Now, for questions like these, you don't have to think too much or wait for long, right? You just give your answer directly. Don't say, let me think and then give your answer. So basically, you would use fillers in part 3 of your speaking exam. Let's have a look at them now. The first one is very easy and we always use it in our everyday life, which is well or hmm. And you can combine these with the next ones, which are let me see or let me think. For example, the examiner asks you, why are online businesses flourishing these days? So you could say, well, let's think, and then give your answer. For some answers which are quite complicated or for some topics that you don't think about very often, you could say, well, that's a pretty interesting question or that's a tricky one. For something which other people do and you are asked to comment about that, which is quite common in part 3 of speaking, you could say, I guess or I suppose. For example, the examiner asks you, why are family size getting smaller these days? So you could say, well, I guess one reason could be, and then give your answer. And finally, you could say, I haven't really thought about that before. For instance, the examiner asks, some people say that more people in the future will work from home. What do you have to say to that? So you could say, I haven't really thought about that before, but it is foreseeable that, and continue with your answer. So guys, these were all the fillers that you can use in speaking part 3, but remember to use them appropriately and in the right context. For that, you can continuously practice at home and get better with them. Tell me in the comments which fillers do you already use or which you're going to use now in the future. And I'll see you next time with another video.